Building and deploying AI solutions and services can be very straightforward or very complicated. It really depends on what the tools you're using and what the expected outcomes are. Today, we're going to talk about the first step of that, and it's really how do you implement AI? And we're going to go through the steps that you should follow to ensure you can implement a very effective AI solution. Welcome back. Thanks again for all of the support for this channel. I'm really enjoying all of the feedback that I'm getting from folks, and I'm really looking forward to continuing this series. So if you watched the first two videos, we talked about kind of a real high-level overview of what AI is, and then we talked about some business cases for AI, you know, how organizations are currently using it and ways that we're seeing them to optimize their operations, improve their customer service, and those types of things. Today, we're going to talk about the first phase of implementing an AI solution within your organization. And we're going to break it down into five categories. We're going to look at planning, data collection, model development, testing, and straight up deployment. So when we look at how we're going to plan this out. First things first, we're going to define our project scope, right? We're going to identify the specific problems or opportunities that AI is going to help us with. We're going to look at the expected outcomes and how we're going to measure them, right? Next, we're going to set the objectives and our success criteria. We're going to establish some very clear metrics and goals, right? So we want to look at things like, let's reduce our customer service response time by 30%. Let's close our help desk tickets by 50%. Things like that. You can define success metrics such as improved accuracy, cost savings, and time efficiencies. Next, we're going to develop a roadmap. So we're going to create a timeline that outlines our key milestones, including things like data collection, model development, testing, deployment, and post-deployment monitoring. Next, we're going to look at risk assessment and mitigation. This is a big one, right? We need to identify any potential risks such as data privacy concerns, bias in algorithms, or even technical challenges that we might run into. We're going to need to develop a contingency plan to help address those risks and really make sure that we're putting a safe product in front of our employees, in front of our customers, wherever it's going. So now step two, we need to look at the data collection. Okay, there could be numerous data sources. You could have a single set of data that you want to use for this project. It all depends on what you're trying to do with it and what those outcomes look like. As part of the outcome, you should really know what those data sources are and what data you're going to need to develop your solution. Next, we're going to do some data preprocessing. This is things like data cleansing, looking for missing data, making sure our data is at least somewhat accurate, and bringing all of that together in a usable fashion. We're going to look at things like data annotation. So if you're working with something like a supervised learning model, ensure that the data is accurately labeled to train the algorithm. We need to make sure that we are using the appropriate labels as we go to develop what our AI tool is going to look like. Next, we're going to jump into actually developing the model, right? We're going to select the appropriate algorithm that is really based on the problem type we're trying to solve. So is it a classification problem? Is it a regression problem? Is it a clustering problem? And we need to know what the data characteristics are. What data are we using? We need to look at considering factors like interpretability, scalability, and even computational efficiency. We need this model to run effectively and as quick as possible for whatever it is our business objectives dictate. Next, we're going to build the model. Right? We're going to develop multiple models using different algorithms to compare performance. right? You're not just going to use one model and say we're done, because you want to use different algorithms to test how well it's going to work, how accurate it's going to be. You're going to use techniques like cross-validation to make sure that you're not overfitting. This is kind of machine learning 101. We want to make sure that the model is balanced and that we're not going to have any kind of inefficiencies in there. We're also going to make sure that the model generalizes well to unseen data. So if we're bringing in data that we're not using right now, and we wanna bring that in to train the model further, things like that, we wanna make sure that we're accommodating that. We're gonna look at things like hyperparameter tuning. So we're gonna fine tune our model parameters, which are things like, you know, let's see, for instance, you know, learning rate or regularization. And we really want to do this to optimize the performance of our model. Next, we're going to evaluate that model using metrics for things like accuracy, precision, recall, F1 score, and AUC ROC to evaluate model performance. All of these tools can be used in a lot of the open source toolkits and frameworks. And again, this is really what it's required for data science 101, machine learning 101. Next is the testing phase. We're going to validate the accuracy of our model. So we're going to split our data into training, validation, and testing sets to make sure, or at least to test the model accuracy. We're going to perform benchmarking and back testing if we're doing like time series data or something like that, or we're going to cross-validate to assess the model stability. We're gonna do some stress testing. We're gonna simulate any of the edge cases in extreme scenarios to test the model's robustness. We don't want it to break while our users are consuming it. We're going to analyze the model's performance under these different conditions. So for instance, is the data noisy? Are our inputs incomplete? And those types of evaluations. Next, another biggie. We need to ensure that we are looking for any kind of bias and fairness. And so we're gonna do some, or fairness issues, right? We're gonna do some testing on this stuff. We're gonna evaluate the model for potential biases that could lead to unfair or discriminatory outcomes. We're gonna implement fairness metrics and adjustments as needed. Right. So if we need to ensure that we are not leaving out any groups, we are accommodating all areas that need to be covered as part of this model. This is a really important thing when we talk about building responsible AI. Finally, we're going to deploy the model. Are we integrating, you know, with our existing systems, right? We're going to ensure that that AI model integrates seamlessly with our current workflows, our current applications, or our software systems that we're using. We're going to use things like APIs or microservices or containerization, things like Docker, Kubernetes, that type of stuff, to be able to deploy these models easier and deploy our applications easier, as well as accommodating for scalability. We talked a lot about infrastructure. Then how do we deploy it, right? We have to decide between, are we going to run this on premises? Are we going to go to the cloud? Are we going to go on-prem for now and then go to the cloud, somewhat creating a hybrid environment? Are we going to go to the edge on IoT devices or running in very, very small containerized applications? We need to look at things like data security. What are the costs going to be? How much does it need to scale, right? We need to be able to project out how many consumers we might have in the near and longer term. And then we need to consider using things like A/B testing or phased rollouts to really deploy the model gradually and mitigate any of the risks, right? And then finally, we need to do our post-deployment monitoring. We need to test the accuracy of the model again. And guess what? then we need to go reiterate and see if we can make the model more accurate. We need to bring more data in to do more testing. There's a whole bunch of stuff that goes into, and we talk about that as machine learning ops or ML ops. So when we're looking to implement, these are sort of the key stages that we need to consider as we're developing our models and deploying them to our applications. Next, we'll start talking about some of the deeper aspects of this in our next video. So hopefully you found this helpful. This is really just an AI starter kit, and looking forward to seeing where we go from here. Thanks a lot for all the support. Please make sure to subscribe and like and all that good stuff. And we'll talk to you soon. Thanks. Bye.